The topic of our project is OER Repository Platform. I am Sonakshi, he's Ankur, Vaibhav, and Harshvardhan. Open educational resources. What is an OER? OER are freely accessible resources that are used for teaching, accessing, learning purposes, and for research purposes. They are released under Creative Commons license. The question arises, why do we need a platform? So the requirement of a project is to create a unified platform for searching the contents, which is user-friendly. We have made the platform in a software called DSpace. Now, Vaibhav will continue.
Good afternoon. DSpace is an open source repository software platform that we have used to develop our platform. DSpace, a lot of people won't be familiar with DSpace. So let's get some idea about DSpace. DSpace was developed on Java Spring Framework, and it uses various Java technologies for various functions. It provides interface for administration, deposit, ingest, and search and access. Now we'll look at the various technologies that DSpace uses. Now talking about user interface, DSpace has two user interface. It supports two types of user interface, JSP UI, XML UI. We are using XML UI for our project. It has Solr for indexing, searching. It contains, for database, it has Oracle. It supports Oracle MySQL database, also PostgreSQL database. This is DSpace architecture, sir. Whatever field we have circled, we have worked on those parts. There is an application layer, business logic layer, storage layer. On application layer, we have worked with web UI. We have configured it. Like by default, we were using XML UI. We have configured it with a theme created by Atmeyer. We have used Mirage theme. Also, we have used Bootstrap to configure the UI to change various stuff. In search field, in business logic layer, we have modified search filters to make it more educational, make our website more educational. Also, we have worked with authorization and submission workflow manager. This is the current hierarchy of DSpace. By default, DSpace has this hierarchy. It has top level community, second level sub community, collection. Inside collection, we can have items where we submit the digital contents. From sub community, we can further create collections and sub communities, and this line goes on. What we have done is we have treated this as a discipline or department. This will be our course. This is lesson. Inside lesson, we submit items. We have modified the hierarchy like this to suit our needs more. So what happens by default in DSpace is DSpace gives default read policies to everyone. So if user has to contribute or he has to add a module, he has to ask for the permission from administrator. Now let's say we have 100 users, 200 users, and there are like two administrators, and everyone wants to submit. It will be very problematic for administrator to grant rights to everyone separately. So what we did here, we changed the default policy of DSpace from read to read, write, edit, read, write, add. This way, any user who has an account can submit a course. This created one more problem, is that the problem of security. Let's say I create a course and he creates a course. I should not be able to modify his content, or he should not be able to modify my content. So for that, we have changed the, whenever I create the course, he will just get the read write, and I'll be the admin of my course. If I want, I can add him as a submitter or reviewer or any other role, but I will have the admin write over my course, and I can just read his course. Yeah, now Ankur will.
Coming to the metadata schema, this whole DSpace system is based on tagging, and this tagging is based on the metadata schema, and this initially, when we installed DSpace, there were some 67 fields which were provided at initial for addition of any new item. And those fields were not enough for the assets which were uploading, like the PPTs, the PDF, and the scanned documents. So we just, we found a learning object metadata which were more oriented towards learning resources. And from there, we identified some 9 metadata tags which were top subject, which defined what the item was related to, topic, interactivity type, it defined whether the topic was of practical or it was theory based, learning resource type, context, format, difficulty, if the course is difficult or is easy, and the learning time. After changing the metadata schema, we were required to reflect those schemas while submission. So these were the schemas which were added by us, difficulty level, interactive type, intended end user role, which usually tells the viewer that who's, like, for the digital assets, who are the targeted audience. And initially in DSpace, like DSpace works on Solr in the background for searching. And by the, its default, there were some 5 fields upon which we can items can be searched. And those 5 fields were not enough. Like those fields were usually topic, author, the date of its issued. So anyone who wants to search any learning resources, it was difficult for them. So we modified our search engine so that it can include more 5 metadata tags.
Only you increase the number of metadata or the any algorithm you have changed?
Which
algorithm you are using right now?
It uses Solr. Like Solr uses inverted indexing and it uses research.
Binary search
in its background for searching.
So have you tried some lattice search or something? Which is basically used in the educational field, very popular.
So at present this system, like the Solr was provided in the system itself.
You improved the search, that is why I'm asking ki what improvement you have brought. One thing is that you have increased the metadata.
Yeah,
but that doesn't mean that you have improved the search. You have improved the metadata.
Yeah, like we
search improving in the sense?
Increase the number of items.
So because even if I'm coming on the system and I want to search like...
Why can you substitute those five with your five tabs?
So I have added the more 5 with that 5. Like I increased from 5 to 10.
Why? So why to replace the 5 which I used?
So those were more relevant. Like initially you would require those 5, but to make it more accessible, like the extra 5 were added.
Sir, the point was to make it more educational wise. See sir, let's say C programming course, it's taught in class 9th, 10th, 11th, and even in first year, sir. So we have added one more field which says which kind of course it is for school level or high school level or engineering level.
Collection of metadata is manual or automatic?
So it's a manual. While we are submitting an item, we have to provide the metadata schema.
Yeah.
So then as far as this slide is concerned,
yes.
I am saying that just you have increased few more metadata, but there is no intellectual work in this. Just increase the metadata, people have to fill in manually and then
so no, sir, like search the will main do. System was like when DSpace was like initially configured on our system, and it provided some set of 67 fields. Like those were not learning resources oriented. So we needed it to be more
you customize it.
Yeah, we needed it to be more towards for a system. Like it was like for a general sense. Like when you are uploading a file and you describe the file like what's the date or who's the author of that file, what's the type of the file, and but giving this metadata.
But it is only the changing labels. There is no as such logic available for this, no?
So this is required because like at present our system loads the files like in our in this internal server, and we have thought of importing data from other systems.
We will be more impressed if you have created the metadata automatically, if you have brought some intelligence kind of thing. It's okay, customization is also work, but it is a laborious work. It is no intellectuality available. He is saying assets, I am saying learning resources. So it is just a label change. The content is same.
No, sir, but
and he has to fill the content manually. So there is no automation available in between.
We change the metadata keeping in mind that like at in future we wanted the system to import data from other resources like MIT OCW and other.
So whether there are some APIs or something you have written to like pull the content?
Yeah, there are SWAT server in this DSpace to access the data. Like we were not able to configure it, but it. If the system is...
We are more interested in your work. What is available is okay. What I am saying that you have created any API or something to map the content of the OCW to the DSpace or something, some bridging you have done, then we are very happy. If available, it's okay. That is available.
Main sense was that like this is an open source system and there were no available documentation for anything. So configuration itself was a
that is the challenge before the open source things. Many time documentations are available.
Even if changing is little source code, like we have to go through something around 1,000 files.
What is the language they have written?
It's in Java.
Java.
The backend is in Java and the front end, like it has two type of front end, XML UI and JSP UI.
Okay, and so database?
Database, it's PostgreSQL.
Postgres. Okay.
And just database was just for the authorization, like it shows the user documents.
Then the content he put
content
into?
Content is done by tagging by Solr.
So then this all metadata and other things, where they are going to put?
It actually
file
it's
storage system.
File storage.
XML.
Yes.
XML or a text file?
Sir.
Where the hashtags or the your
sir,
metadata?
Solr has a JSON file, like it has
JSON.
All.
Okay.
It has all the tagging of whatever.
Right. That is the best practice actually, yes because sir. It is the fastest search
yes
rather
sir.
Than
yes
the
sir.
Databases.
Solr was the best search engine available at
right.
like for metadata. These were the new t- types which using that which we can search. And initially, like, there were no, like, this system was just for, like, you can upload a file and you can download a file. And, like, there were no any way, like, you can view the file, like, media files, like, videos, MP3, audio, and image. So we, like, changed the source code of and integrated plugins for each of the files which would mostly require.
Which codec it will support?
It's supposed, like, for MP4 and WebM. MP4.ASC codec.
Which player you have used?
So I'm actually using a web video JS plugin which supports
the native player or something else?
No, it's a video JS plugin, JavaScript plugin, which implements both Flash and HTML5. Like if the browser is a legacy one, it will fall back to its Flash.
So
Flash
it is a HTML5 built-in native player?
Like it uses its own codec for streaming the videos.
Okay.
Because and that was required because if we were using HTML5 inbuilt tags, and this system was not able to play the videos as the video being of large size, and DSpace were not providing those size in the actual way to render the videos, so we were forced to use a video JS.
Like let's say a file is 1 GB and it starts downloading, user doesn't need to download that file. Like he can see it first and then decide what does he want.
It's fine. That I understood. Good.
And even PDF streaming plugin we use because mostly our system consists of scanned documents which are most like on 200 plus MB.
So video streaming plugin means what you have used?
I use PDFJS.
PDFJS. Like so again, it is a Flash dependent then?
No, it's HTML5.
HTML5.
It's HTML5 dependent. It's actually the PDF plugin used in Mozilla.
User should have Mozilla only?
No, it's a plugin which is actually integrated into the Mozilla.
Okay.
But it's an offline plugin which have integrated it, which can be used in any browser.
So somebody has to download the plugin?
No, there's no need of downloading. Just I can show you the demo. So like automatically the PDF streams and you can see the content. And this, like it doesn't have to require, like even in legacy browsers it supports. User interface and we'll like to show the demo.
So sir, this is our user interface looks like. So there are the first hierarchy, as you told you, departments, then courses, then lessons, and inside lessons we submit the items. So currently we have two departments that we have made, computer science and mechanical. Lessons, inside course also. So
suppose I just want to add my open educational resource to your thing, department, I'm not a course.
So you can submit that in a department. There is the provision that without.
I'm not a course.
Sir, there will be a like right now it's not there. There will be a like something like others or something where you can upload everything that's not related to that.
I don't understand when you're talking about open educational resource repository platform.
Yes, sir.
Okay, where does the department and course come into it?
Sir, we were basing it. More on college.
On what?
College level.
For what?
Sir, like.
There is an OER repository by Government of India.
Yes, sir.
Okay. It has no department, it has no this thing. It is topic.
Yes, sir. What we did.
With the open educational resource, who the hell cares whether it's done by IIT Bombay or IIT Madras?
Sir, what?
Why the hell do you care?
Sir, but the department, what we meant here is not the any government. It's like. Your content might be related to some mechanical department or computer science department.
So it's a topic.
Yeah, it's a topic.
Departments.
Why course?
It's a course in like.
Sir, we can call it module, sir. It is like a module.
Why module?
Sir,
I don't understand.
Sir,
so because
I want to write something about pointers.
Yes, sir.
I got an educational resource.
Okay, sir. There is.
Where? How the hell do I put it?
Yeah, sir. There is two things. You don't need to create a course. You can just have a lesson. Lesson as in, you can just say pointers and you can upload your content. You don't need to create a course for that. We are providing that functionality.
That's what I'm asking.
Yes,
we are providing that functionality.
So that is also there. Like in the computer science department, if you have a standalone lesson.
I'm not a department.
Sir, the course is related to that department.
Sir, not inside department, inside the topic. Inside the topic.
No, what about cross-disciplinary? Come on. I don't understand why you are rigid. If you're coming into open repository system, this is rigid.
So we wanted to have a.
Heat engines in aircraft. Can't alunga mai.
The best practice is that you should have the labels user-defined.
Labels
whether
user.
You say computer department,
okay.
Computer
exactly.
And electronic
yes, sir.
Department,
mm-hmm.
yes.
Information technology department, whatever.
Can I put it under two departments?
Same course under two departments.
No, I am talking about resource here. Yes. I am not going to talk about anything. I got an educational resource.
Yes, sir.
Can I put it under three departments? That's what it is.
One is to
I don't understand anything else. Yes, there is an educational resource. all the structure you're building is supposed to tag that resource. It doesn't have to belong to anyone. Belonging is my problem. Okay, I don't mind tagging it as anything.
Okay, so if we make that user different.
Interdisciplinary is common.
Yes, sir. Yes,
now,
sir.
And it's going to become more common. Anyway, yes, go ahead. So you got this. Go ahead.
Sir. Like there's this course on data structures and a lesson on linked lists. So here, this is a video which can be streamed. We have added those plugins for image, video, and audio as well. And
understood.
Apart from this, that search.
Understood.
So if you want to search, show advanced filters. If I want to search all the videos that I've uploaded on this portal, so I'll give the type video.
No, no. Keep it video, no? I want to see if you're smart enough to add I. Are you?
I don't think so. It will search.
VID.
No, he's not
smart. No, sir.
I asked him if he's not smart enough.
So, because it searches the string, substrings of all the tags.
Because you say content.
Yeah.
Otherwise, give the drop down.
Sir, there is one more thing. Let's say, sir, PDF content or doc file, and like it can
no,
search
all
from
this is given by the DSpace, correct? You have not done anything.
Sir, okay, sir, what we have done is, sir, let's say, like what was not there by default in DSpace.
Instead of title, I can drop something else.
No, sir, like we can search in the content. Like if I need to search a word and if it's in present in any of the PDF documents. So that's searching the words
good.
Will give me the occurrences in all the PDF documents.
That you added.
Yeah, it gives the occurrences like if I'm searching linked list and I have a PDF document with a lesson of linked list. And
okay,
you searching.
Now there is a one question now.
Yes.
What happened basically in such kind of systems when you search and you will go inside the PDF and pull it out.
Yeah.
There are two issues which comes many times. First is that okay, whether I should have a right to see that. For example, if I search Mr. Outage's balance in the bank, if it is available in his repository. But whether I have got the right to see that, but your search will pull it and show it to me, whether it is taken care of first.
Sir.
Second thing is that many times the jurisdiction is not defined, then it will bring so many search results like Google that I cannot get the appropriate thing what I want. So how you have control both the issues?
Ranking.
Yeah.
So the ranking thing is already supported by the Solr. Like it ranks each of the documents according to the like
frequency,
if you have searched
frequency
of the words you are searching
in the document.
Like relevancy, like the word you have searched, it assesses all the text relevance. Like it calculates the probability of that letter and creates a ranking of that items. So it gives a more appropriate search results.
What about the rights of the user? What
so it's
answer?
Open source. So like that at default we are allowing
okay, open source also there is a right. If he is an admin, he has got separate right. I am a user, I have
yes
got
sir,
a separate
yes sir,
right.
I talk about that, sir.
He is a teacher, he has got a separate right.
Yes, sir. Like, I am a normal user right now, sir.
Hmm?
Like, what I can
no,
do
no,
is...
No, I am asking the rights for search.
Rights for search?
Yes. If I am civil engineering student, that I have got only rights to search civil also, or I put in
no,
civil
sir,
engineering in search, and then I will get computer also, and mechanical also, and
no,
everything,
no, sir,
which are irrelevant.
Sir, you can search in that particular, like, there will be this...
No, no, give me a specific answer, don't play with that.
Yes,
give
sir.
The answer.
Here you can search a particular department, like right now.
Oh. That also I have to give. It should take from my login, from which department I belong.
So, but if the civil engineer also wants to search computer things,
then I specifically mention, but I should have the rights. See, what I am saying that I cannot see his financial things.
Yes.
The reason is that I am not empowered. Forget about the general thing, I am not worried about that. But which I didn't have rights whether your search will dig it out. Normally, I didn't have the navigational right to go there. But search will many times pull it out.
So, but if you upload it on the open source repository, it will be available.
Yes, sir, it's an open source
they
repository.
It, searchable
so,
by everybody.
Sir, the purpose of the project is to search any kind
okay.
of...
So, you can answer like there is no rights provision.
Yes, sir.
It's okay.
Answer another basic question.
Yes, sir.
You have this space. Customize it for open education resource.
Yes, sir.
What is special? Apart from adding 5 tags.
Sir, special as in, sir, that was not
apart
there
from adding 5 tags.
That was not there before. In
apart from adding 5 tags.
Yes, sir.
And giving this artificial boundary of department and course and whatever. Actually forgotten that it's an educational resource. The educational resource is a separate resource by itself, exists by itself. And it has got a topic which has to be used for searching. So that plain thing has been lost somewhere. And I think that is the most serious flaw you have done. Because when I come in, I'm not interested in anything. I'm interested in learning about a topic. So what are the resources in that topic? Learning about a keyword, what are the resources in that topic? And I expect you to figure out that a topic belongs to computer science, does not belong to human distribution. That department is immaterial for user. So I think you have lost that. Okay.
No, sir, but because of the metadata schema, we can uniquely identify each and every item belonging to a particular department. So there is
no... No, but I think your requirements are wrong, no? Your requirement should be how to classify large amounts of open education resources. That was the second question I was asking. How do I know that what you have done, okay, is scalable? That's a fantastic word of his.
So like the DSPARE system is highly scalable because across the globe, like thousands of systems are using DSPARE alone for storing all these digital assets. And they're mostly digital assets are like around in TBs. So like it has a capability to be scaled. Like we didn't get the resource to
scalable
check
in terms of response time.
Yeah, like
for search.
For search, if you're asking, like the Solr search we are using here is some like almost efficient.
Yes, but for some reason, this DSPARE animal, okay, thinks that only 5 criteria is enough.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yes,
so, according to me, DSPARE itself thinks that it is not scalable beyond 5. Why can't I take it like that? Because
so
you're not tested.
So DSPARE.
So DSPARE was not like it was not constructed like
meant
keeping in mind that it will
sir.
Be meant it was not meant for educational alone, like it was as a repository for anything, like
yes
across
sir.
Institutes it is like customized according to their requirements.
Sir, I'm getting your concern, sir. The thing
why
is
5 to 10 was my first question. If it is educational,
yes.
Okay, it has no other data except educational, so it's a DSPARE instance only for education. Why can't I restrict my
DSPARE is not only for educational.
It is not, but you have configured it for education.
Yeah,
no. So,
if you want to search like a particular for as you.
I don't want to get biography. It is not educational for me. Why are you putting it there? DSPARE is meant for something else. If it is meant for education, then all I need to do, probably in my view, is to take those like you have done. We say community is equal to department, this is equal to class. Similarly, to the, I will change title. Title is equal to department. Why I need title? Aisa kuch karo na. Why extending 5 to 10 is a risky proposition.
Yes, sir.
I don't know if that's very distinct. Anyway, anything?
Yes, sir, we can consider it.
Huh? Okay, go.
Okay, sir. Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.